What we saw yesterday was the energy levels of the rigid rotor, right? Now, I'll think about the energy levels for the harmonic oscillator. Those were all equally spaced, right? The distance or the energy gap was always h cross omega. In the case of in the case of rigid rotor, what you have is the energy levels are, so if I write in units of h cross square by 2i, right, then the first energy level is 0, then 2, then L into L plus 1, right? So 1, 2, 2 into 3, 6, and then 3 into 4, 12, sorry, it will go much higher, 12 somewhere over there. So you see the gap in this case is 2 in units of h cross square by 2i. Here it's 4, here it's 6, and the next one is 8, 10, 12, so on and so forth. If I were to record an absorption spectrum, so of a molecule for measuring its harmonic oscillator properties, let's say, then the spectrum would come out to be, so what is the spectrum first, maybe? You have a source of light, it falls on a sample and it goes to a detector, okay? And this source, okay, there's a monochromator also, so it's a monochromatic source of light, so one particular frequency comes at a time. If you wish, I could add that monochromator here. So as I change the frequency and plot the intensity of light, okay, with the sample minus without the sample, right? So intensity of light with the sample minus intensity of light without the sample, that is I naught is with a blank. So what would happen is that you have the intensity of the light, right? And then suddenly the intensity of the light diminishes when the sample absorbs. The sample would absorb when the energy difference is equal to this particular h cross omega, or h nu for that matter, for that particular frequency. So the intensity of sample would fall down, the intensity of light anyway with the blank remains a constant. So there will be a dip and it will go something like that, right? So this is what will happen, only one dip if I assume the harmonic nature, then it's only one dip. Okay, whether it goes, whether the particle gets absorbed from here to here or from here to here, it's exactly the same amount of energy that is required. Okay, now in case of the rigid rotor, what do you think will happen? Before, equally spaced set of lines, very nice, but right, and the separation between these lines would be 2 into h cross square by 2i, right? So if I were to increase my frequency and use the same thing, is minus i naught. But before you could say that, you should have known one thing, or rather two things. One is something known as a selection rule. As somebody in the class, this morning class, was asking me about transition dipole moments. I am not going to that. Oh, maybe I could just briefly tell you. The transition dipole moment Well, for that, all it says is that if this is my final state, then a transition dipole, a dipole moment is essentially, we treat this light for electrical dipoles. Okay, for these particular cases, we just need the electrical dipole, the magnet, not the magnet. And the electrical dipole for a one-dimensional case, I can just write as charge times distance. Charge is a constant, so I can just write the charge outside, distance in psi I dx. That is what I'll, so all space I have to calculate, right? So this gives rise to the selection rule that it tells me which particular final state can be achieved if my particle is in the IF state. Okay. It so turns out, well, if you think about the harmonic oscillator, well, if you want, you can actually do that for the harmonic oscillator, but for that what you'll have to do is to read all the properties of Hermite polynomials that are also given in Atkins. You could do that. But otherwise also, if you think, if I and F both are odd, then the combination of that makes an even function. X is an odd function. So the entire integral becomes odd, goes to zero. If both of them are even, then also it will happen. The only case it will not happen is when one is odd, one is even. And if you do the entire calculation, what you realize is it's possible only from state I to I plus 1. Okay. So without doing the calculation, I cannot tell you from I to I plus 1. I would say I to I plus 1, I plus 3, right? Not I plus 2. But with the calculation, what you get is that delta V is equal to plus minus 1. Is what comes out for the harmonic oscillator, right? For like, I mean, in a similar fashion, if you look at the Legendre polynomials that are also given in Atkins and try to do the same thing, you also get delta L is equal to plus minus 1. Okay. Now, the thing is that, which means that I cannot have excitations from state V is equal to 0 to V is equal to 2. So 2 h cross omega is not allowed under the harmonic oscillator approximation. The moment it becomes anharmonic, all these things get allowed because the symmetry gets disturbed. Okay. There's another thing that you must know, and that is that this rotational spectroscopy that you do, that is done in the microwave region of the electromagnetic spectrum. And the vibrational spectroscopy that you do is done in the infrared region. And the kind of things, translational thing that we saw for butadiene, 1,3 butadiene, we saw that was close to 400 nanometers, that is in the ultraviolet visible region. So that is a much higher energy, IR is much lower than that, and microwave is another 1000 times lower than that. Which means that the energy level spacing between these is 1000 times lower than the energy level spacing between the vibrational levels. Okay. And at room temperature, if I am doing my spectroscopy at room temperature, then I would be interested in knowing which particular states are populated so that there an excitation can occur or not. So if I were to do that at room temperature, all you need to do is to use the Boltzmann equation and see that the number of states populated in level 2 divided by number of states populated in level 1 should be equal to e to the power minus energy 2 by energy 1, right? That's what Boltzmann tells me. So, it so happens that, then let me tell you the energy is also, at room temperature, the energy kT or RT is roughly, RT if I say it will be per mole, so kT is per molecule, is about 27 milli electron volt, room temperature energy. That is the energy provided by